Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Shashi and I'm a runner. Guys, today I'm going to talk about VO2 max. What is VO2 max? When you run or exercise or do any other high intensity workout or sports, you need more energy compared to when you are at rest. Now, how do you get energy? When the glucose stored in your blood is burned, energy is released. So, what is required to burn that glucose? Oxygen. So basically, you require more oxygen during exercising or running. Your performance as a runner or as an athlete depends upon the ability of your body to utilize oxygen during the activity. VO2 max is the measure of this ability of your body. So basically, VO2 max is the maximum rate at which your heart, lungs, and muscles can effectively use oxygen during the exercise. Higher your VO2 max, better will be your performance in your sport. VO2 max is not just important for a runner or any sports person, it is also important for any individual. A high level of VO2 max means a greater cardiovascular fitness, which means longer lifespan, reduced risk of heart strokes, better quality of life, better mood, and better sleep at night. Now the question is, how can you improve your VO2 max? VO2 max of your body depends upon a number of factors. It depends upon how powerful is your heart, how efficient is the oxygen supply system in your body, what is the level of hemoglobin in your blood, how dense are the capillaries in your muscles, and how rapidly your muscle tissues become active during the exercise or running. All these factors are determined by your genetic makeup, but they can also be influenced by training. You can improve your VO2 max by doing intense exercise or intense running for shorter duration of period. You can improve your VO2 max by doing interval training. First jog for 10 to 15 minutes to warm up your body, then run as hard as you can for 2 to 3 minutes. After that, walk for 2 to 3 minutes to recover, and then repeat the interval. Like this, do 3 to 4 intervals in the beginning. Later increase it to 5 to 6 intervals. These intervals are like a strengthening workout for the muscles of your heart. These intense intervals make the muscles of your heart stronger. Stronger the muscles of your heart, better is their ability to pump blood per beat. You must do interval training at least 1 to 2 times per week. Besides this, when you go for a long run, you should make interval training part of your long run. In fact, you should make tempo run also a part of your long run. I'll tell you how to do that. Suppose you are going for 2 hours long run. For first 30 minutes, just run easy. After that, for next 30 minutes, run at comfortably hard pace. Try to run at a pace which is hard for you, but which doesn't drain you off. That is a kind of tempo run. For the next 30 seconds, do interval runs the way I mentioned you before. And for the last 30 minutes, do again the easy run. If you make tempo runs and interval runs part of your long runs, your VO2 max will greatly improve. You should also sometimes challenge yourself to run your best 5K or best 10K. This again takes you out of your comfort zone and trains your heart. This improves your VO2 max. The high intensity interval training workouts which people do at home are also very effective in improving your VO2 max. I have made a video of 12-minute HIIT workout. The link is above. You can try that workout. And internet is flooded with lots of HIIT workout. You can check out those also. Some of the high intensity interval training exercises are jumping jacks, burpees, jump squats, jump lunges, mountain climbers, etc. I'll be making more videos of HIIT workout. Keep checking my channel updates. Turn on your notifications so that you get to know when I upload those videos. lots of GPS watches tell you your VO2 max, but don't rely on them too much. There is a specific test to measure an athlete's VO2 max. The athlete has to run on a treadmill and he breathes in a tube. That tube collects the air he's exhaling. Gradually, the gradient and the speed of the belt is increased, and the athlete keeps running till he is totally exhausted. Then total amount of air exhaled by him is measured. That is nearly equal to the oxygen he takes in. And from that, his VO2 max is calculated. Your GPS watch cannot accurately measure your VO2 max. So don't rely on the VO2 max given by your GPS watch. If you do your interval training and your tempo runs religiously, your VO2 max will improve and you will realize it, because you will be able to run faster and longer with less effort. You will get less fatigued. That is how you realize that your VO2 max has improved.